Hello everybody, Dan here. This is part two of a video about how I write my monthly newsletter. In the first video, I talked a little bit about why I write a newsletter, and it is most likely not for the reasons that you think. It is not for sales, it is not for anything else, it's more for friends and networking and community. So if you're interested in that, I definitely recommend going back and watching that first video. I'll link to it in the description below. But in this video, I'm going to show you how I write my newsletter. And there are three main tools that I use to do that. The first is going to be Obsidian, which you're looking at right now. The other is going to be Things, and I'm going to show you kind of how I use Things for this newsletter and for other things. I'll give you a peek at my actual things. And then the last is Substack, which is what I am currently using for my newsletter. I don't actually charge anybody for my newsletter. I don't make any money from it, so I'm only costing Substack money, which is why I haven't moved. If I were to ever want to monetize it, I might move somewhere else just because there are some other better options. But for now, it's Substack because it's all free and I'm only costing the company money. As I've been making more Obsidian content, and it's been, I don't know, maybe about almost 2 months now, so not that long, I've been thinking a lot about how I can differentiate myself from other Obsidian creators. And I think one of the ways that I can do that is by showing minimalist Obsidian systems. Because I feel like a lot of the things that I have set up in Obsidian are sort of the minimal viable versions of something that works. And when you're looking at a lot of videos on YouTube, you're going to see a lot of really complex systems, a lot of plugins, a lot of advanced things going on. And I just don't have the time to like learn that and muscle memory it and set those up and play around with it. I really like to actually do things in Obsidian rather than playing with it. And playing around in Obsidian, so setting up plugins, doing all that sort of stuff is totally valid. Just make sure that you're conscious that that is what you are doing and that is how you want to be spending your time rather than actually doing something else in Obsidian. So I think part of this video and part of my other videos is showing you how you can set up something like an email newsletter that goes out once a month with a minimum viable version of it. So I'll show you what I have set up. I'm sure there are additional ways to add automation, to add complexity, but here is what I have. And I hope that me showing you this can be useful to you in setting up individual systems in various parts of your Obsidian vault. Yeah, I think that's about it for the intro. Let's dive in and take a look at what I got going on. All right. Let's jump into Things to start with. So this is my Things inbox. I'm kind of showing behind the scenes. I'm not the best at processing my inbox. I give you permission to not be the best as well if that's just not you. The way that I have things organized is a modified Para version. So Para is Nick Milo's system, I believe Nick Milo. But Para, P-A-R-A, is like the trendy way to organize it. And I sort of have that. So I have this top section are my most used areas. I sort of have the Dan Chronicles, which is my newsletter. I have a section for things that I just want to add to Obsidian one day. So often I'll just, Things is on my phone. So when I stumble across a link, an idea, a thought, somebody mentions a movie, I see a mention of a 60-minute segment I want to watch, I want to turn off location tracking on new Google accounts that I create. When I think of any sort of idea that's anything related to anything, a song I want to download, I'll add it to my inbox. And then every so often, I'll go through my inbox and I'll organize things. So this is something that I want to mention in my newsletter next. So I might click this, click the arrow, and do Dan Chronicles. And then this is something I want to mention in my next newsletter, maybe. So again, Dan Chronicles. And I'll kind of go through here every so often to see if there's anything that I want to add to Dan Chronicles. And then anything else that I kind of see of like, I don't want to really set up this anymore. And so every so often I kind of go through this and semi-process it, but I'm really bad at getting inbox zero. There have been periods in my life that I have been better at that, but I have not actually found a substantial additional value by regularly doing inbox zero. It's like minimal value, like it's a little bit better, but it's not really that much better. And so I haven't really beat myself up about trying to constantly be at inbox zero. But this Obsidian inbox is something that I review regularly. And the Obsidian individual projects that I have here, I review very irregularly. So I need to know, personally for me, if I'm moving something from my inbox to a folder, it means I'm probably not going to look at it for a while, because that's just how I work. So oftentimes I'll leave things in my inbox just because I want to be reminded, because I'll review this when I have a few minutes here and there, just to remind myself what's actively on my mind. The two folders or the two projects that I often will look into is the Dan Chronicles, because again, this is for my newsletter. So I'll have, okay, ideas. Maybe I want to do temporary tattoos. So that's kind of a thing in here. Maybe an enamel pin, but go cheaper from Alibaba. And then sometimes there's different articles or different things that I'm considering mentioning in my newsletter. So that's sort of how the Dan Chronicles in Things work. I use the inbox to capture any idea, any link, any thought. And then I will, if it is related to the Dan Chronicles, I will move that into this project. From this project, typically I do most of my work on the newsletter out of Obsidian. So let's see this right here, the Havana Syndrome 60 Minutes. I'm going to just copy this. And then in Obsidian, I have this monthly newsletter page. So this is like the monthly newsletter map of contents, or MOC, but I don't actually have MOC in the title. I could, it's just a style choice. I probably should to keep it unified across all of my stuff. But for now, I just have it monthly newsletter with a little emoji to kick it off. And in this newsletter section, I have a next week on. And this is kind of where I have a running list of what I might want to talk about in the next newsletter. So throughout the month, I'm kind of filling this up with ideas. So this was from Things. Let's go back to Things. I can check this off because I no longer need this here. This is a movie that I kind of wanted to mention. So let me move this over here. Great. So now I moved that from Things and I can check it out of Things. So every once in a while, I will move things from Things into Obsidian. And this is going to be really where I work on my newsletter. So on my newsletter MOC, I have reference links. So a link to Substack, a link to my newsletter landing page on danb.org. And then this is a tool that I use sometimes to enhance audio. Although I haven't really been using it for my podcast, but I do use this for videos oftentimes. And then here's a button that creates a new newsletter, which I'll use in a second. And then here is a copy of the template for each newsletter. So I'll click on this in a second too, but let's just continue on down here. So next week on, this is my most frequently used section of the MOC because I'm actively adding things and then working from here as I'm writing new sections in my newsletter. Here's where I just have reference to past events or past things that I've done. So in October 2023, I had a charity t-shirt drive. In a past video, I was wearing that t-shirt, but it's a fun Dan Chronicles thing that I'm very proud of because I designed in Figma. And then I also did a holiday sticker giveaway in 2023, December, for the holidays, just to remind myself of sort of what I did in relation to my newsletter on certain dates. And then this is the cool thing. All of my past newsletters are in this data view table. So I can see at a glance sort of what emoji I used, because in the title of each newsletter, I'll use an emoji, as well as what were the five topics that I wrote about in each newsletter. So if I can't remember if I've already mentioned something, this is a quick way to go back and review and kind of search to see if I have mentioned something, or if I remember talking about something and I want to call back to it, I can also easily find it because of this. And so this is super handy. And because I use a template to create all new newsletters, things are automatically going to be added to this. So right now it's the very beginning of April 2024. I haven't created my new template for the new April newsletter yet. I usually send it out the second to last Monday of the month. So I have a little bit of time, but since we're here, let's just create it together. So the first thing I do, The last edition was 41. And so the next one is going to be 42. So let's click this button to create a new newsletter. And here we are. The first thing I'm going to do is change this to 41. That's what I said, right? I'm going to reopen this 41. So this needs to be 42. Wonderful. And this created a new email from a template. So let's open that template to look at them side by side. So this is the template that I'm using. It has all of the front matter as you would expect. And let's move this. There's source mode. It's kind of cut off in this video. But if you click this, you can just kind of see the code version of your note. So you can see I have the properties here just formatted like usual. I usually like to write properties just in the source mode because it's easier for me. And then I switch back and turn off source mode for editing. For tags, I have monthly newsletter. I use publish just because I put published on anything that I actually put out into the world. I don't really change this from non-published to published. And so all just the template I have published on there, which doesn't actually do anything, but it's there anyway. And then this next bit of code is going to move this file to spaces/monthly newsletter, which you can see here, spaces/monthly newsletter. And then it's going to use the format. And so it's going to create a file with this file name format. Again, this is going to put today's date in the year in the proper format because this is how I like to do it. And then we'll move this back out of source mode and close this. And then I usually have, like I said, an introduction in my newsletter and then five different sections. And each headline usually has an emoji and a witty or snappy headline. And so I include that text here just to remind myself to always have an emoji. At this point, like I said, I've done 42 of these, so I pretty much have the muscle memory. But I'm going to go through, and usually I have monthly notes open in another tab so I can look at next week on, let's say, Havana Syndrome. Let's say I want to do this, and this might be good in the second slot. So I might put that in here. Just so that when I'm going back and I actually want to write this section, I know that this is what I want to write about, and then I can remove it from here. So throughout the first weeks of the month, I'm usually working on a section here and there as I feel inspired. And then typically the weekend before it goes out, because I send these out on Mondays, I'm spending a few hours finishing off the newsletter, anything that I didn't write, recording the podcast, because there is an audio version of this, and then scheduling this in Substack. And so let's take a look at the last newsletter that I wrote just to see what it looks like finished. Great. I'm going to close this. So after I write all of these sections and I add the witty title and the emoji, I'll go back through and add them to the topics. So usually I'm editing this section in source mode. So let's do that again. So I'll go through and be like, okay, this first one I wrote about Balatro, which is my favorite game of the moment. So I write Balatro in here. The next one is Dax Flame. And so I'll write his name. And usually I try to be as short as possible because, again, this is going to show up on the monthly newsletter page. And I want it to be just a short trigger to me as to what I wrote about. And then I write this summary. So I'll use these five topics to write, okay, Balatro, a new video game obsession. So kind of hints or teases at what is in the newsletter. And this summary is something that I use in a few different places in the newsletter. Okay, so let's turn off source mode. This is what a newsletter looks like. Let's jump over to Substack real quick and take a look at that. So here we are in the Substack dashboard. And the new post, I usually do audio, like I said. So I click this to create a new post, and this automatically makes it a podcast episode as well as an email newsletter. I usually do this after I write the draft in Obsidian, so I'm not going to do that right now. But let's take a look at a past post just to see what this looks like. This is the March newsletter, the last one that went out. Edit this post. So typically I use the exact same format just so there's a uniformity to each of these newsletters. The Dan Chronicles, March, and then I always pick an emoji and try to make it unique for each month. And then I mentioned the summary in the past section about Obsidian. And so this is usually where I copy and paste this. And this is also the tag that I also use when sharing things on social media, although I am terrible at social media and sharing there. So that is an area of improvement that I need to work on. And then I just copy and paste everything. And let me actually show you, because that's a cool little trick. So there is a plugin that I use. It's called Copy as HTML. And Copy as HTML remove WikiLeaks brackets and replaces it with a regular link. So Copy as HTML is a plugin that you can install, and then you can assign a hotkey. If I go to hotkeys and type in copy as HTML, you can see that if I hold Command Shift C, rather than just Command C for copy, so if I hold down Shift while doing it as well, it's going to copy all of this in HTML rather than in Markdown. And I find that this enables me to copy and paste from Obsidian into Substack without having to play around with formatting. Because usually if you copy and paste it, it's going to be in Markdown format. So if I instead just select everything like this and do Command Shift C, it's going to copy this entire post as HTML. And then I can go back to Safari, go back to Substack, and then just copy or just paste in this, and it's going to be formatted all correctly. Usually after that, I'll go through and just make sure everything worked correctly. I'll add a few buttons here and there for callouts, for additional sharing, things like that, call to actions. And then I add this image at the very top of the email that I designed. And that's it. Again, I record the podcast, which I'm not going to go over in this video. I get everything set up, and then there are a few select people that I send a draft to for just an extra pair of eyes before this gets scheduled. And again, this usually goes out the second to last, so the penultimate Monday of each month is what I target. A few months I've missed that, and I've instead sent it out on the last Monday. That's sort of why I do it the penultimate, because there is a backup if I just don't get it done. But yeah, that's how I've been doing it, and that's how I've been doing my newsletter for the past, I don't know, 40 of 42 different times. And I find it's a really great system that enables me to create really fast, to capture ideas as I have them in a system that I can trust and use, and then have a robust history of all of my newsletters all in Obsidian. And that brings us to the end of the video. If you have liked this, please give the video a thumbs up, please subscribe, all of those things that everybody says. I mentioned I'm sort of new to Obsidian, so I'm getting a feel for what videos I want to create and what people want to see. So please leave a comment if you've enjoyed this, and I will see you, or you will see me, in the next video.